تعالى الحديث الحادي عشر عن أبي محمد الحسن عن أبي محمد الحسن بن علي بن أبي طالب سبط رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وريحانته رضي الله عنهما أنه قال حفظت من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم دع ما يريبك إلى ما لا يريبك. رواه الترمذي والنسائي. وقال الترمذي
يريبك لو كان فتح الياء عن الله يسلم عن فتح الياء. I think it's mistaken. يريبك فتح الياء.
دع ما يريبك إلى ما لا يريبك. رواه الترمذي والنسائي. وقال الترمذي حديث حسن صحيح.
طيب جزاك الله خير. طيب and here in hadith number 11 we have a new sahabi narrating this sahabi preceded. And he is the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His kunya is Abu Muhammad. His name is Al-Hasan. And his father's name is Ali ibn Abi Talib. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, the fourth khalifa of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his son Al-Hasan narrated this. And his kunya is Abu Muhammad. He said, I heard from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and I memorized from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the following statements. Ta'ma yaribuka ila ma la yaribuka. Leave that which makes you doubtful for that which is not doubtful. So in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, remember, he categorized the affairs here into two things. Those things that make you feel uncomfortable and uneasiness in your soul and in your heart. And it's more, they say it's more comprehensive than just the word doubt. So I use uneasiness and uncomfortness. So this feeling of uncomfort in your heart and uneasiness in your heart is one state of some of the things that you see. And secondly, things that you don't find any uncomfort and any uneasiness with. Some things that you find uneasy with, some things that you don't find uneasy. That's what the Prophet ﷺ categorized the things that come al-walidat ila al-qalb. Of being. And so the Prophet ﷺ, he quite simply instructed us to leave off those things that make you feel uncomfortable and uneasy to those things that don't make you feel uncomfortable and uneasy in your heart. دَعْ مَا يَلِيبُكَ إِلَى مَا لَا يَلِيبُكَ. Simple. So if you have two foods, this food, you feel uncomfortable. And there's reasons why, not waswas. We're not talking about waswas. Waswas is that you have, let's say COD.
OCD.
Sorry. OCD over everything. You go to a shop, a Muslim shop, and you see he's a Muslim, and he's got a beard, and all the guys in the back, they're all Muslims. And he says halal on the door. And they ask, brother, is this halal? So that's just being extra. We're not talking about that. We're talking about there is actually a reason why. For example, you went in a shop and you saw that, for example, there's no sign that says halal. And you saw, for example, the person wearing a Sikh thing that they wear. And you saw other things. So you had doubt, maybe, and you heard, for example, someone told you they use the same oil for this and for that, for pigs and pork and for this. So it caused you to have doubt. And then you know the next shop is a halal shop. What are you going to do? Khalas. As for if there's this type of shop and you don't have any uneasiness in it and you think this is halal or you know it's halal, then khalas, you don't have OCD back in my shop. But this uncomfortness and this uneasiness occurs in those affairs that are doubtful. As for those things that are halal, those things that are haram, they're clear. As we mentioned in the hadith earlier in the last sitting, the affairs are three types. Either it is halal and it is clear, or it is haram and it is clear, or it's a doubtful matter. The doubtful matters, what do you do? Stay away from. Like this uneasiness, it occurs in those matters that are doubtful. So if you have uneasiness in a doubtful matter, stay away from it. As for if you don't have unease in that matter, because the doubt here is nisbiya. It could be doubtful for you, but it's not doubtful for him. He knows it's clear haram, or he knows it's clear halal. But for you, you didn't have the knowledge for it, so you're doubtful. So you stay away from it. So this hadith, it occurs in those things that are doubtful. So if you have unease about something, then you stay away from it. For that thing which is clear and it doesn't have any uncomfort about it. And to give you a small example, when we're sitting with our Sheikh Ali Nasir al-Faqih, Hafizullah, he's still alive, from the major scholars in his Medina, and he was teaching us this book, Al-Ra'in al-Nawawi. And there was a general folk, someone from Amat al-Nas, who came to him and he said, Sheikh, I have a question. Tafadhal. Sheikh, I have two miswaks. This miswak is Sini, is Chinese, is made. Look, it's plastic. Look, Sheikh. And I have this one. So, Sheikh, is it allowed for me to use this one? Tayyib. Sheikh said to him, were you in the class? We were studying this hadith. He said, yes, Sheikh. He says, khalas. He took the two miswaks from me. He said, which one is doubtful? This one. What about this one? No, it's clear. Khalas, leave this one, which is doubtful for you. Just have this one. Khalas, simple. This is a qa'ida, am fi kulli shay, that you should use in your daily lives. Leave that which is doubtful for those things that are not doubtful. Khalas, tasla. Tayyib. And that's the end of that hadith. Last hadith for today.